Hey, don't forget this week and next September 25th through October 3rd, subscribe to paper.exceldailynews.com for a chance to win a free entry to Model Off. Learning Stuff from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1793, Ctrl+T Table, the Default Formats Don't Persist. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Well, today's question is actually an idea from Quinton. Quinton's from Jacksonville, Florida. I ran into Quinton last week at my seminar in Daytona, and Quinton noted that when you create a Ctrl+T table and create a format, so Ctrl+T, you know, you get this nice little formatting, but you can go in and customize the formatting. So right-click, duplicate, and then we can change things. Let's say that we want to change the first row stripe to be two rows tall with, fill of this orange. Click OK. Second row stripe, two rows tall with a fill of that blue. Click OK. Click OK. All right, so now we have this new format. We can define it or use it. And also we can right-click and say that we want to set as default, right? So that all sounds good, except for when you do Ctrl+N, go to a new workbook, create a new table, 1, 2, 3, with Ctrl+T, click OK, we don't get the default. In fact, the default isn't even here, and the problem is that that custom table format that we created is only in the workbook that we created it. So it's only a default for that workbook. Like if I would create a new table here, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and Ctrl+T it, then it's the default here. But it's not the default in any other workbook. That's a horrible way to go, right? So Quinton had asked this question just after I showed a trick for how to create defaults for all future workbooks that you open. So this is a horrendous set of steps. It's over here. I'm going to walk through all of these here in the next couple of minutes, but you might want to freeze the video at this point and just kind of make sure that you go through all of these steps. If you have my book, Learn Excel 2007 through 2010 from Mr. Excel, these steps are on page 46, a horrendous set of steps with the exception of the table steps. All right, so here's what we do. We're going to create a brand new workbook, Ctrl+N, make sure that workbook has one sheet, temporarily set up some sort of a table. And it doesn't matter how big the table is or what's in the table, we just have to set up a table. So simple, Ctrl+T, click OK. Then we're going to choose a table style that gets close. So if you see any colors here that look remotely like what you're trying to use, by all means, go ahead and select those. So we'll choose that one. And then right-click and say Duplicate, and now we can go through and customize. So we want the first row stripe to be 2, we want the second row stripe to be 2, and we'll change the format of that second row stripe to something else. Click OK. There's all kinds of things you can customize in here, right? Click OK. And then, see, it doesn't change the table. It just creates a new item here in the list. So we'll apply that table, right-click, and say Set as default. So we've now defined the default table as this format in this workbook. But at this point, we can get rid of that table. So I'm going to do Alt-EAA, which is Edit Clear All. Of course, that is somewhere out here under Clear All. There we go. All right, make sure that you're up in A1. Now, optional step at this point, and this is what I usually talk about when we define a new default workbook for all future workbooks. If there's anything you want to change, like for example, if you always go to page setup and say, you know, page one of question mark, if that's your standard, or you always put confidential or highly confidential or something like that, by all means, go make those changes here. Fit to one page wide by blank pages tall, you know, any other settings that you want to use all the time. For example, I always like to use the narrow margins, 0.25, 0.25. I even go 0.25 at the top, and then 0.5 at the bottom because the footer is going to be at 0.25. So these are the changes I make all the time. You make your changes. Other than that, it's going to look like a completely blank workbook. All right, now we're going to go into File, Excel Options, go to Advanced, scroll all the way to the bottom where you have this setting, at Startup, Open All Files, and this is blank on your computer. So you're going to type some new folder in there. I called mine Excel Start. You can call it whatever you want. Make sure in Windows Explorer you go create a folder. So Windows E, go to the C drive, and I already have my Excel start. And it's empty right now, there's nothing in it. Because if there was something in here, it would automatically open when Windows opens. Okay, but we create that folder, and then this workbook, the one that has the default table style, file, save as. We're going to save it as a template. If you don't use macros, you're going to use XLTX right there. If you do use macros, XLTM, I'll pretend like I don't use macros today. And that then changes to this horrendous folder deep, deep, deep down in the folder structure. So we'll go back to C:\XLStart. And we have to use a special name of book. So you use the file name of book. And then do another save as, file save as. And this time save it as sheet. So book and sheet. There we go. I'll close this, file close. And this is our set of steps again. So we went through all of those steps. And then the last step, very important, when we're creating a new workbook, you need to use Ctrl+N. This is particularly important if you're in Excel 2013. Do not come here and do File New. That takes you to this blank workbook is not the Ctrl+N workbook, which is even worse in Excel 2013 because they force this on us right there on the opening screen. This is not the Ctrl+N workbook. This is something else. So Ctrl+N looks like a brand new workbook. Looks like nothing is different, but in fact, if we go into page setup, the changes that you made are there. So page one of, the margins are narrow, fit to one page wide by blank pages tall, all that's there. And the added benefit, if you create a table in this workbook, and Ctrl+T, click OK, your default table style from the other workbook that you set up, you know, maybe weeks, months, years ago, will apply to this workbook as well. So an interesting way to actually use default table styles and have them work in future workbooks by saving it in the book and sheet templates. Hey, wait, don't end it yet. Let me reiterate, Excel 2013, they open to the start screen. This blank workbook is like doing file new in Excel 2010. It is not the book template or the sheet template, it is something else. Don't click this, instead just click escape, and that will load the book template. Now you have to go into Excel options here and change that, add startup, open all files in. However, once you do that, restart Excel 2013, Ctrl+T, click OK, then your heading styles will, even if you set it up in 2010, it'll come over to 2013. Just remember, don't use the start screen, which is the same as doing file new. You have to just escape out of that, and the version of Excel that the Excel workbook that you get or the Ctrl+N workbook will have the right settings. Well, hey, I want to thank Quinton from Jacksonville for that idea, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.